We are a dedicated team of hardcore outdoor enthusiasts committed to conserving hunting and fishing traditions. Although the technology changes, we still strive to cater to everyday outdoorsmen. If you like fast-paced, hardcore southern hunting and fishing action, keep up with us and hold on. We are 704 Outdoors.
.704 Outdoors TV show is brought to you by Barefoot Archery, North Carolina's leading archery dealer since 1966.
Hey guys, this is Josh from 704 Outdoors.
And I'm Ashley Reep. Come experience with us my first buck kill.
We're going to go up to Alleghany County in Sparta, North Carolina. We're going to go up a week earlier than we do. We go every year. We usually go in December. We're going to go up in Thanksgiving week this time, see if we can't catch deer more in the rut. So stay tuned and go with us. On this hunt, we got there a little early. I got my Viper arm set up in a tree. I was gonna film her. We got set up, I had my stealth odorless outdoors. We sprayed down real good for that because I knew the wind was gonna be blowing. And we had our big game butter set up out there on the corn pile. And then we didn't start seeing deer till a little bit later in the morning. So we had the crossbow with us, just to be on the quiet side because we didn't know what we was going to see there that first morning. Everything started out calm.
This spot couldn't be much better. The little river runs right behind us. Next thing you know, little doe comes running through, acting silly, getting chased by some little spikes behind her.
Then we had this little yearling come in. She just come in real slow. It's a good thing we were sprayed down real good because she about picked us off, but she just couldn't quite tell what we was. But she went on about her business. She hung around there probably about an hour or so, maybe an hour and a half. And we had deer all over us after that. And there was some in the field, some on the road. Yeah, we sat there all morning long, about lunchtime. We got bored and things started slowing down, so we decided to climb down and go over to our other hunting location. It was probably about 400 yards away. So we went ahead and eased on over there to it.
We're set up in a prime location. There's a huge scrape to our left, a corn pile to our right, and a mountain straight ahead of us. They worked their way down to come visit.
We got a whole lot of trail cam pictures of some good bucks. I don't know, of a 9-pointer and an 8-pointer. Them was our two target bucks. Whichever one was going to come out, that's the one we was going to try to get.
professional hunters. Looking for that perfect bow, crossbow, or archery accessory for your next hunt? Barefoot Archery in Charlotte has exactly what you need. Our professional and friendly staff can help you purchase the perfect bow and arrows for your hunting or target practice in our shop, and we'll teach you how to use it. Need practice? Check out our indoor archery range. New to archery? Moms, we offer archery classes for homeschool and after-school students, as well as private lessons. So no matter what level you're on, we'll get you on target at Barefoot Archery in Charlotte, located at 4410 Old Pineville Road in Charlotte.
Light up the night with sniper hog lights and take down some hogs. Our new all-steel exterminator feeder light is solar-powered to put out red light all night and keep the big hogs around. Reach out and touch a pig at 800 yards or more with our brand-new models. And our mini sniper blows the competition away from your rifle or bow. Light up the night with Sniper Hog Lights. Visit sniperhoglights.com to pick yours up and knock them down.
Norris Merchandise is your one-stop shop destination. Need new furniture or to fix something up in your home? We have all the hardware you need and carry quality designer furniture like Lane Home Furnishings at rock-bottom pricing. Going hunting? Get your ammo, knives, hunting apparel, and boots here. Looking to purchase a new bow? Let our highly trained archery technicians in our pro shop help you find exactly what you need. Norris Merchandise, where getting what you want is easy. 2011 South Lafayette Street in Shelby, North Carolina.
Yep, that's right. Your prey just picked up your scent and he's gone. Not to mention, you've got your own unwanted company. So how do you stay close to your prey and keep the pest away? You need the brand that keeps your scent under wraps and repels ticks, chiggers, spiders, and lice. You need Stealth. Stealth products are made with natural, non-hazardous ingredients, so you blend into your surroundings without alerting your prey. Whether you're on the marsh or in the field, you can hunt with confidence, knowing you have the advantage.
Stealth. We've got your six. Get yours.
This segment is brought to you by D&K Skull Mounts, skull mount specialist and home of the $30 skull mount.
So we put the crossbows up, we got the rifles out. I'm feeling really determined to get my first deer, hopefully a big buck, but we'll see.
All right, the last morning, Wednesday morning, we got up, tried to get up pretty early. We left out about 4:30, and it was pouring down raining. I mean, it's like the bottom fell out. We checked the weather and it's supposed to change to snow by daylight. And sure enough, it changed into snow. Probably about 7:30, 8 o'clock. We looked out there and there was this buck and this doe standing out there eating out of his corn pile. The buck was just checking her out. Finally, he left and the doe started playing around. She just came right up under us and just looked at us like she was like, I know you're there. All right, after sitting in the rain, snow, we done got snowed on probably 4 inches. We decided we was gonna climb down out of the tree and just ease back towards the truck and go try to warm up for a little while. Still kind of early, it was probably 11:30, 12 o'clock maybe, so we decided we'd climb down and just rest for a little while because we done put in so many hours in the tree. Probably had maybe altogether 16, 17 hours in the tree the past couple days. Just going to rest.
We're coming back in. We got our clothes all dried off from this morning's hunt and the 4 inches of snow we got. It's about a mile walk in just to get set up into our tree stand.
Okay, after we got back, after we got dried off and everything, we snuck back into the stand. And before I had my camera on back up, before I had anything set up, we already had deer all over us. We had bucks, we had does, we had bucks chasing does, bucks chasing bucks. Everything just happened so fast, I couldn't even get my camera arm up. So I had to freehand everything from then on.
get at me. I can't believe you got that close. That was perfect. Go ahead and try and call me Muddy.
Well, after I shot, I couldn't wait to get down and go check out what I got. Hopefully he's laid down in the woods right next to us.
Big game butter, whether it's foreign attractive, for trail camera surveys, or for year-round deer nutrition. Big game butter gets it done. High in protein and fat, rain and mold resistant. Deer find it fast and come back often.
There's all this talk around town about how great Howell's Pawn and Gun Shop is in Concord, North Carolina. People keep talking about all the different gun manufacturers they carry, like Glock, Springfield, Smith & Wesson, Remington Arms, and so many more. And I hear they have ammo, holsters, stocks and grips, and specialize in gun repairs, modifications, and custom builds. Plus, they have any style of gun, whether it's for sport shooting, hunting guns, or tactical weapons. Howell's Pawn and Gun Shop, 595 Church Street North in Concord, North Carolina.
Attention all hunters! Looking for that perfect bow, crossbow, or archery accessory for your next hunt? Barefoot Archery in Charlotte has exactly what you need. Our professional and friendly staff can help you purchase the perfect bow and arrows for your hunting or target practice in our shop, and we'll teach you how to use it. Need practice? Check out our indoor archery range. New to archery? Moms, we offer archery classes for homeschool and after-school students, as well as private lessons. So no matter what level you're on, we'll get you on target at Barefoot Archery in Charlotte, located at 4410 Old Pineville Road in Charlotte.
When it comes to jewelry, you know what you want. You just can't find it. McPherson's Diamonds and Design. Your vision can come to life through the expertise of master jeweler and owner Richard McPherson's custom jewelry design. He'll take your design from sketch to sample mold and into the truly unique piece you've always wanted. And with in-house on-site repairs, you never have to wonder where your jewelry is. Every item is repaired by us, and we will always keep your favorite pieces looking like new. McPherson's Diamonds and Design, an expression of you that shines.
This segment is brought to you by Busted Arrow for all of your hunter's clothing and accessory needs.
My wife was too embarrassed to get on front of the camera, so she shot this. It's probably about 245 now. It run probably 60 yards. Pretty good shot, and there was 3 bucks running with one another. She didn't get the one she wanted. We're gonna climb back up in the tree, see if we can do it. Stay tuned.
Well, I got my first buck, and he's a nice one. Super wide 8-pointer, but that's not all, guys.
Well, after she killed hers, it was still early. It was about 2:45, going on 3 o'clock by the time we got him drug out to the road. So we went on back to the same stand. And after that, you know, we didn't see no more deer. And last second, last night, it was just out of camera light and everything. She grabbed my grunt call, and she hit it 3 or 4 times, and this dude stepped out, and I laid it to him, so. This is what he looked like. I want to give a special thanks to Blackwood and Deer Lures for bringing them in, Stealth Odorless Outdoors for keeping us hidden, and Big Game Butter for keeping them fat.
We're going to bring it back over here to Anson County now. We're going to be hunting Wadesboro on a morning hunt. It's a late season, December 6th, buck hunt. Hoping for anything. This hunt's going to take you through how to identify signs and how to place your stand. And it might even show you how to kill a good management buck. So y'all stay tuned. Here it comes, baby. Straight from the 704.
Hey, y'all. It's Cornbread here. 704. It's December 4th, 2014. And this year's hunting season's been a struggle. Trying to find a decent buck to shoot. We're down here in Wadesboro, North Carolina today, and we're going to be setting up a climber spot real quick. Just got to figure out where, so y'all stay tuned, and I'll show you the signs and what I look for as to where I want to put my climbers and how I'm going to hunt every situation in the woods.
So one thing I'm always looking for is deer travel, which way they're going and coming from. And I'm also always looking for rubs and scrapes, but you can see this is one of our main power lines that run way down. It's approximately about 1,500 yards long, and I'm always looking for which way the deer are traveling down it to help me decide where how I'm going to hunt it. Right here's a prime example, pretty good size set of tracks, and they're all traveling that way. So we're going to go down and start looking for some more sign and get something set up.
All right, so this is a tripod stand I've had set up here for probably 10 years. I built this thing back when I was in college, but I sit here a lot and I use it as a observation point as well as a hunting spot. Killed a lot of deer out of it, but the past 2-3 years, I've noticed that the majority of the deer movement is taking place on the far end of the property. So that's what we're going to be focusing towards, and we're going to get down there and look for some more sign. All right, so we're about 3/4 of the way down the power line approximately, and as I said, we've noticed a lot of the deer movement down the far end, and as you can see, we're starting to see some good sign. Now here's a pretty good rub. I'd say about a 3-inch diameter tree. Should be a decent buck. So I'm gonna use information and sign like this to help aid in how I'm gonna position my stand to be able to kill a deer like this, hopefully. All right, so we're getting pretty close towards the end of the power line. This is actually an area that me and Kayla both bow hunted some earlier in the year. We haven't been in here in a month probably. Missed the whole rut. And I believe I was hunting the wrong places at the wrong time, because you can see right here, that's a big rub. So hopefully he's still running around, and we'll be able to see him hopefully. So there's definitely a good quality buck in this area right here.
This segment is brought to you by Dawn to Dusk Outfitters, located in Anson County, North Carolina, specializing in whitetail deer and turkey hunting.
Buck in this area right here. All right, y'all, so I found the area I think I want to set up on. What we got is a pretty good looking hardwood bottom coming through here, and we got pines on both sides, and this is the far end of the property. The end of the power line is just right there, and I can tell we got a lot of deer traffic working this. A lot of deer sign. We got rubs everywhere, all through the area, and looks like a good feeding area down there and bedding area. So what we're going to do here is we're going to set up a climber right here in this tree up here. As you can see, I already did my trimming. I cut this tree and a few twigs and stuff all around here. Trying to get it opened up a little bit. But yeah, we still got a pretty good cover up in this tree. This tree we're going to set the climber on right here, and it'll give us a good clear shot all the way to the bottom. And this is going to, and I think I like it so much that we're going to put a stand in this tree next year. And a little more trimming, and we're going to end up putting a food plot on this spot right here. So we're going to get it set up, and we'll be back in here. I'm planning on coming Saturday, December 6th. And hopefully we're going to put down a big deer for you.
Hey y'all, Cornbread here. December 6, 2014, and we're going to be doing a morning hunt. So we're going to get in there and get set up and get that Viper tree arm rolling. So y'all stay tuned. Y'all, so I got a buck coming in. He looks pretty decent. December 6th is getting late season. I've ate a buck tag for the past 2-3 years waiting on a good buck. This is just a good management buck, it appears. So in the meantime, it's about 9:40. I grunted about 5 minutes ago, if that. My dad sent me a text just now saying he's gonna get out of his stand, come over here. He wanted to see where my spot's at, so I can actually hear him coming from behind the path coming up to me, and I gotta make a quick decision. Am I gonna shoot this buck or not? So let's see what happens. Damn, that was quick. Whew. How fast was that? Oh my God. He just popped out of nowhere. And he's down for the count, baby. It's been a tough season. I've been letting a lot of bucks walk, and I think he looks pretty decent. This is a spot that I set up 2 days ago. And a lot of big rubs in here. I was like, man, there's got to be something decent coming through here. So I hurried up, set it up. It's December 7th, I think it was. I don't know. And you see it right here. It was that quick. Buck down. Let's go check him out. He's probably not the biggest thing in the world, but hey, I am happy with him. So let's go take a look. Y'all, not huge by any means, but late season buck. Never had a big buck on camera in here in the past 10 years, but this is our biggest we've taken off this property. Definitely not our biggest you know, ever by any means, but y'all seen how he answered to that Bob's Custom Calls. Awesome call, did a great job for us. No worries, you know, had a doe in here early, had him come through, never got winded. And you see where the footage come from, how smooth it is, that's that Viper tree arm for you. So I want to thank all our sponsors, y'all. If it wasn't for y'all, we wouldn't have this down. As many successful hunts as we do get, it's because of y'all. So, I'm gonna get them rounded up.
This show was brought to you by Barefoot Archery, Sniper Hog Lights, Stealth Odorless Outdoors, Norris Merchandise, Big Game Butter, and Howe's Gun and Pond.